Welcome to Star Sector, a major freak. Yes, I know. Sudden burst of narration. It'll go back to just music in the future for a while. I think I'll do this sparingly. So, where we left off, our heroes were about to engage what I assume are pirates, but definitely it looks like they're a bounty. Usually tell that right away by the exclamation mark. And it is this person right here. I'm not going to engage them because I stupidly, I've been having errors trying to record this video. And I've had to reload a few times, actually, taking so long. And I'd forgot to get more personnel. I'm really low in personnel right here, and shockingly low. Luckily, I had enough to... I checked the videos, and I'd not brought... I thought I'd brought extra and just dumped them in the resources at... Beta Watson. In resources. I must have done it a previous playthrough and just forgotten I'd forgotten. these are being... I don't know why they're not mine anymore. They're being neutralized, and I think it might be this person doing it. I don't really know if the remnants bother. I haven't a clue. I'm not going to bother with them, really. I might want to put in a... it's not going to engage me, by the way. So I'm just going to ignore it. And go back. What I'm going to do is go back home. Get more crew. And... Okay, I've got a comm sniffer. Great. Yeah, that's what I plan on doing. So I just left it there. And off we go. And I'll take off on... home. And I'll come back and deal with those people later. But what I wanted to do is deal with the pirate base and I just went back, got my crew. Actually, where am I? I wish there was a button that would center you. Is it home? No. Where I am here. There we are. I think it's... This is where I left the pods that I didn't stabilize, and I'm pretty sure it's... let's see. I wonder if we can see the pods on... No, if they were stabilized, we'd see them, right? So, I'll go in here. See if I can see them. Actually, I'll go in this one. See if I can see them. No, not there. And they might have despawned. I dropped them... What did I drop them? I forget, actually. Not too long ago. I'm hoping they're still around. They'll pop up on a scanner at some point. I think they're on the other side of the system. I've got a... decent, sensor range. Thanks to my missile cruisers. Is it this? Yes, there it is. Right on. So I'll grab these and head on home. Confirm. And it turned out to be like a quarter of the price of the, you know, the stuff I'd got. So that'll last for 150 days. So that'll be good. And we'll take off. Here, we'll take off home, get 3 tugs, get more crew, dump what we have, and go to the pirate base, which we're gonna metagame now that we know what's there. I just thought it was the pirate base and yada yada, right? But it's actually, the system is home to a bunch of autonomous guardian towers. I'll show you. It'll happen real soon. So here I go, back home. And I always keep I've got one base for all my loot that I keep. I keep 15 of the large, 30 of the medium, 60 of the small, all the weapons. And that's where I keep all my ships that I've got stocked. And of course it's a colony, so it won't charge me rent for storing things there. And I suspect that abandoned stations that you find that you can dump things at, I don't think they charge you either. But if you use outposts, it'll charge you. And if you store it, if you buy storage space at actual populated stations, it'll charge you. So just gonna metagame that because there is an abandoned or is it Manchester's? There's an abandoned right at the jump gate, the wormhole, or the jump point. And I'll put them all in there that I work because there's so much loot there. I'll just keep trucking back and forth, and I'm not going to attack the pirates that are there, so I can use their station to refit and do stuff whenever I need. And then just at the end, actually there's a force that arrives, that a Kadr remnant that goes in to attack the base at some point. So as long as I'm quick, I'll be able to attack the base before they arrive. And I spent 4 months in there, so it 2 hours, so I'm 2.5 hours, so I'm hoping to cut the time down by a wide margin. Now, where are my points? Cut those down. So I've tagged all the stuff that are nearby, and I wish there was some way of removing the fleet logs, like deleting them, because they get pretty annoying after a while. So there we go. So this guy's really crazy. He's actually he's actually in Gamma Sahara right above me, and I'm not going to attack it because it looks really scary for now. This one is the one we just left. That's my storage space. That's just resources right there. And that's the pirate base we're going to leave alone till the end. And yeah, this is extensive runes. There's lots of runes in there. Lots of loot. These guys are going to ignore for now, but I want to take them out at some point. His bounty expired at some point, so I might consider going there first to take him out. Volcanic World and a binary. Yeah, he's pretty easy to find, so maybe we'll take him out first just for the bounty. But I'm getting so much revenue right now, so I don't really need to worry about it, but it would be nice. Okay, and I've got my agents at Oasis, raising relations and procuring a shear, which is not really needed. I'm gonna move her to a pirate base, Queras, the biggest one, the biggest size military base in the sector. So we'll get her on that. Yeah, and I'm not gonna deal with this. It's way down in this corner of the map, which is really huge. I've already dealt with the other storyline. That's completed. I had to look it up. You get this the ability to build gates, actually, but they're really expensive and they need vast ruins. You need to find a planet with vast ruins and then build a specialized industry on it to extract domain era artifacts. And I want to keep these guys friendly because, wow, imagine bumping into that when they're hostile. No thanks. So I'll definitely be using my agents to beef up standings. And there's, once I get to level 61 in Manchester, once we get there. And we'll definitely, we're definitely going to have some dilemmas for the next level, what we want to invest in. And of course, I've tweaked my max level up to 70, so it's getting close, though. I might want to tweak it to 99 or whatever. Just because, why not, right? So, this is all the stuff I've got that's in excess. So I got 15 and then 30 and then 60. And then this is the surplus stuff. And it accounts for all the stuff you have in storage everywhere. So I've got one outpost way down southeast somewhere with some loot in it. That's pumping up my numbers. And this is all the stuff I'm going to sell too. This thing is the sanguinitary stuff. I don't find a use for them. Yeah, and anything that doesn't have decoy flare nor 4,000 range stuff, there are some exceptions, but anything with 4,000 only range and without decoy flares, I'm not going to use at all. So, and let's plunk that in there. We've got quite a lot of metals. Alright. Sort. And I'm just going to keep these things until I see a mission, a procurement mission, because it gives you, I believe, at least two or three times the maximum you could ever get. So I'm just going to keep them around because it doesn't cost anything to store at your colonies, so I'll just wait till I get a procurement mission and scoot back, get it, and complete it within 30 days, and woohoo! And I'll keep this too, for the most part. If it gets stupid, I'll just take it down to Marath and sell it in Maya Rusa system. I forget, it's southwest. Alright. So I've got, I've already got good. And they're barely under strength, yeah. So I'll just dump these guys in there, ignore that. I've got my carriers here. These are great, by the way. I actually want more of them. And of course, I need to get these damaged more. Yeah, that Papillon upgrade, especially for the automated defenses we'll find in Manchester. Expanded recovery shuttles. 8. I've got 10 left. Hogwark light, that's really I have Hogwarks. These are really hard to get actually. How much do I have of them? Yeah, I got Sarah right now. Too bad my agents can't procure weapons. Alright, so Hogwark Lysias. And flak. What is that? It is a... I can't use the auto fit because it won't work for this kind of ship. Especially with a makeshift shield generator. Yeah, it's just... And this one actually has the... No, it doesn't. Yeah, it's crazy damage. You get like plus 30 points, so that's pretty cool. Whoops. Burst vision. Burst cannon. How much is it? 7. Burst vision. Oh. Crap. Burst vision. There we go. Medium ballistic. Don't think we'll get the flak gun. I don't think that's possible. Yeah, look, 93. We're maxed out. Okay, we'll leave that. Till we get more damage, I think. Extended shields. Do I even have... No, I don't. Do I? Yeah, I don't need that. So you get flak, which is 8, I think. There we go. Awesome. And I get 2. There. Cool. Hang on. And I don't have another Timid, so I'll just make Timid. Guide. I'd love to go around looking for officers, but it just, I don't really know how to tailor, because I look for old guys for the carriers, just so I can tell them apart, right, and quickly level them up without... T too much confusion, because it can get really confusing after a while when you have this many. Okay, so I need old guy, and it's anyone with a beard, really. Like, that guy will do, really, honestly. Scarred, that would probably work, too. You have limited options, and anyone with whitening in the hair, that'll do. That guy I've already got, and he looks too young. Yeah, so... let's see, I don't think I've got a list on my cell phone. I've picked 8 traits for each of the tactical stuff. And I don't think, yeah, gunnery is definitely not on that list. Yeah, I just don't want to... I might actually want to switch it because I've got combat endurance, but I keep the carriers, and well, the carriers are going to need combat endurance just for, because they do drain their CR, even if they're out of range because they're fighters, but missile guys don't, so I don't really need combat endurance for the missile anymore, but I will need it for Timid, so Cautious will drop the combat endurance, but Timid would keep it. And so, yeah, I really don't want to get rid of that, but the weapon recoil would be good for, you know, stuff like Vulcan cannons. Alright. Wow, that computer sound is really loud. Turn on some fans here, see if I can quiet that down. Alright. Alright, so defensive system is not, and damage control, nope, and evasion cells, nope. So none of these guys have what I want in traits, unfortunately. I just keep making them. Yeah, it can get a bit... yeah, that's why I don't want to... that's why I gave up with the... I wish you could customize the look, you know? And the name. Well, you can already customize it, but I wish you can customize the look, because if I can customize the look, then I would be willing to try hiring officers, but then you... sometimes you don't get a chance. I wish I could hire just level 1 officers, or, you know, low-level officers. So they wouldn't have that many. Because if you have like a level 6 office, you'd never get the skill set you wanted to begin with as a template. So yeah, it's unfortunate. I wish there's even a way to have your officers follow a certain tech tree for skills. That would make it, yeah. Alex is probably not going to go for that, but that would be cool. You know, you could tailor it. But anyways, I'm not a programmer. I wouldn't know how to do that. Or if it's even possible. Right. Cross your fingers. These guys would be aggressive. I've got the females for Reckless and the robotic looking... unisex people as Steady, and Reckless and Cautious for the female. So that would be Steady, that would be Aggressive, kind of Scarred, but yeah. What do you think? White hair, Scarred bit, yeah, okay. And I think he'll do. And I'd love to have that old guy. That'd be great. And in fact, we need as much carry as we can on this, so, alright. So we'll cross our fingers. Now I always, my guys will always mostly have, the two skills that I have on all of my characters is target analysis and advanced countermeasures, so. Cross your fingers. So power grid. No, I don't need power grid for... Uh-oh. And a common endurance for sure. There we go. Strike commander, perfect. Wing commander, perfect. Carry command, perfect. Awesome. That'll definitely do. Let's see for this guy. Carry command, great. Always never go for this one first. Always goes for these because it gives you options. What you're looking for is options. Is you want as breadth of skills rather than max those skills out right away, because the random nature of the RNG, what you'll get, you need to keep your options open, and sometimes you just don't get a choice. And this is the best, this is the worst, because you know later on it's going to cause problems for your options of what you want to fill your skill set out with. The more you have in low levels, the better. Absolutely, 100%. Because, yeah, the options, you just want level 1 of everything, ideally, and then you're set. Because later on you might have too many of the wrong type, and you're like, dismiss. So, alright, so this guy, so we'll get rid of these guys. And we'll get one more carrier because it'd be really helpful, but I don't think I have any spare. Yeah, I don't have any spare of these guys. But I will absolutely get another carrier. Just metagaming it. What I'm going to be, knowing what I'm going to be facing now. I like this one. It's kind of fun. What is... Peg leg, right, but... Is he... Yeah, he's probably fiercely loyal. Okay, good, good. And peg leg's probably not... too experienced with this one. Yeah, okay, so it doesn't matter really, does it? That will no longer be known as Pegleg. That will be known as Marcellus Damasio? MD. What can I make out of MD? How do you spell that? There we go. And I was using, which one was it? It was the multi-purpose, yeah, it's point defense as well. So 12, so I need 4. Right. So I drop down to, now all these, as you can see, are either decoy drone flare or 8,000, or you know, more than 4,000. These are great actually. I was surprised how awesome they are. So I'll probably just get all of them. And this guy has them. There he is. Crown support package guy. I don't use Marines enough, I don't think. Anyways. That's him dealt with. Really, so it's like kinda cool. It's kinda neat, huh? What is 12? Can I justify? I always like these guys, they're kind of fun. Alright, leave them there. Might as well bring him along. Okay, I don't think I need to make an officer for that guy. Don't really want to. It probably wouldn't be smart. I think I can just shift. Nope, can't. That would just put in the mortar guys, so one of the inheritance. There we go. Yeah, I found that you can add something here, like this guy, and then go to the next one, and just shift, click, and add the same scout inheritance. Kind of cool. I did that for the Badgers a couple of videos ago. Alright, so I've got 22 ordnance points left. Right. The multipurpose. So I'll grab that. There we go. And I've got 18 left. Double shielding for sure. I mean, I add on that most of my non-combats. Shield conversion Omni. Yeah, absolutely. There, done. Easy. And then that'll be fun. Good enough. Yeah, I'm, had to mute the mic. It was wife aggro. So I'm metagaming going against small, nimble, automated drones. So I need a lot of small turrets. That would help. And this one fits the bill. It'd be fun to... I used to watch Star Blazers when I was a kid, so definitely reminds me. Beams would be good. And close range. Storm Needler would be awesome. Definitely do the fit the bill. Turn rate is bad, so what's the turn rate on the Storm Needler? Yeah, I think that's my best bet right there. Could I even power something like that? That's crazy, look at that. Alright, so... anti-armor... What's the range on this? That would be 700. Yeah, only have four of them though. Okay. Antimatic blaster, yeah, that would definitely do it, wouldn't it? That would be hilarious. Gods, that'd be hilarious. Well, the heck not, right? But yeah, let's go healer. Needler all the way. Alright, and... Do I even have enough needlers? I don't. Alright, that was just silly. Alright, cannon, precision mortar, ram and siege, that might fit the bill, but I need 10 of them. Corsair. Isn't that hilarious? I've just not got 10 off each. Too funny. Sponge gun, fission. I'll probably go with this for load, you know, balance the kinetic with explosive. Yeah, 550 versus 600. Yeah, let's go with 600 for sure. Or an attack, I could go with this, anti-armor. Yeah, I'd rather range than, yeah, so, yeah, that'll fit the bill. Alright. Okay. Then I'll definitely need integrated because I don't have any point defense. There we go. And for range, and I don't have any energy, so I don't need advanced optics. Tempting to go for antimatter, but nope. Medium missile. Nope. What is good? Yeah, these are good. Oh, missed that. Medium universal. Oh, geez. Medium hybrid, medium universal. I'll most likely get. Actually, don't even think I have it, actually. I'm looking for this, and I don't think I have it. Nope, and I don't think I have, nope. Okay, I don't have any extra. Okay, it's too bad. If I can get a multi-purpose, that'd be great. But I've got enough already with all those small that I really don't need it. I don't really need an extra point defense at this point. What would be good? It's a medium. Heavy needler, of course. Yeah, why the hell not, right? Go needler all the frickin' way. That'd be kind of fun. I've never actually done this before. So, integrated target needed, integrated point defense, and shit, 4,000, yeah. And of course, I need massive amounts of vents. Only got 13 left. I need shield flux. Look at that. Jesus. Alright. What do we got to play with? Flux distributor, I need 20, so I need seven. These are great, by the way. Want more? Wish I could find some Wisp launchers. Wisp launchers are great. In fact, I can't even get them, so add what cheat here. Wisp. Oh, add shipyard. Wisp launcher. Ta-da. Yeah, they are absolutely awesome. I saw them in action, and I'm like, I want them. My fighters, the Papillon, have them. They're just hands down, just OP. Okay, so did that get me what I needed? Flux distributor. Hell yeah. And I've got 7 extra. Could I just be completely silly? I'd love to be completely silly. Let's do cheese. Why the hell not? Alright. We definitely need to look at stabilize to lower that bloody flux. And hardened shields. 22 left. Yeah, I can't even fit that in, right? Extended shields? No. Efficiency overhaul? Well, yeah. Oh. Okay. Oh, right. Oopsie. Going to be expensive. Expanded magazines? Hell yes. Okay, 12 left. Advanced turrets for sure. 100%. 1, 2. You know what? Should I do a desolator cannon? Yep, we're gonna do a desolator cannon. Alright, 1 hour spawn left. Run simulation. Oh wait. Wave motion. Snort needler. Heavy needler. Achilles. Desolator cannon. Wait. And light needler. Wisp launcher. I'll do alternating for that. Looks like we're good. Right, I don't think I have any drones here. Nope, I don't, so I'll just go with a bunch of really annoying guys. Why the hell not, right? This does. It's probably gonna drain its flux in seconds. Oh Jesus, what the heck? Wow. doesn't say ammo though. Okay, so extended magazines. Caster 12. Accelerated shields 15. So I need 3 more. Thank you. Yeah, okay, sorry about that. Yeah, the point here is to be able to hit things, and this thing whips around all the time, so I've got to get beams, and even then it's touch and go, as you can see. Why do I keep getting malfunctions? So the extreme, oh, okay. Oh. Oh, look at that, wow. Okay. Turning too slow, actually. Yeah, turn right. Just too slow. I need fast-turning beams. And this is slow, so I'd love to get Majolners, actually. Thinking hard about that. Sunstorm could do it. So definitely do it. Wish I had two of those, that'd be fun. Because it look, it's fast and it's perfect. Fit the bill. Alright. 12. 200 per second. I love this Buccaneer beam, actually. It's really cool. Probably... Probably smart just to go Buccaneer beam for this as well. Honestly. Two shots. They're great for Nexorellian mining. What is point defense, but burst fusion? I think this will probably fit the bill, I think. But my wisp launches will just work great anyways. Medium. If I can get a perfect. precision mortar. Precision mortar. Yeah, the railgun. Love railguns. Yeah, absolutely. Railgun all the way. And yeah, I don't have another one. See if I got a real gun on these ships. I pretty much stripped most of them. Do I have a real gun on these guys? No, I don't. Looks like I am S-O-L. S-O-L, alright. List weapons. Add weapon. I think it's just railgun. I don't think so, though. Oh, okay. Cool. Yay. For cheating, but yay for sanity. All right, so I really want to lower that shield flux. I want to speed up the turret gyros, though. It'd be nice if I could accelerate those shields, but stabilize is much, much better. Jesus. Okay, so I've got 6 extra. I think that'll do. Yeah, oh, that will definitely do. This puppy out. This should chew through automated defenses like crazy then. Thank you. too slow? Why are you too slow? Weird. Just seems slower, doesn't it? So Mjolnir. Seriously. Mjolnir. Just love the Mjolnir. 100%. And it's freaking down. Cool. Stuff. All right. Get crew. What? Yeah, by the way, let's go back into that. So I increase the sensitivity of Luddite to 8 from 7. I found they were going active way too early, and I couldn't micromanage just having the AI just under, you know, just not having enough, just keeping this low, just under the radar, so they'd always be sleepers. I don't know why 14, I can get up to 14 here, but on other planets, I can't dare go beyond 12. Like, that's 8, 10, 12. If I go more than that, it'll go active. I don't know why, especially with gas giants are a little twitchy. I was at 14, I think, you know, the others were, and it was going active. I had no idea why. And I had no idea why sensitivity 8 translates to, you could go to 14. Like, I can go to 14 right here. They're still sleepers, so I haven't figured it out yet. So yeah, that's part of it. Of course, this is my refining. It's got the mining, so I'll do refining there, and those are the two industries, and of course I've got a third industry for the military base. That'll be that. All of them are megaports. Oops. And I haven't figured out which one I want to go for. I want to see what the upgraded I want to see what the upgrades for all of them are. Of course, cost, you know, quite a bit. So let's go upgrade one of those and upgrade this guy. Is this guy midline? Midline. So upgrade midline. So we'll see what those look like. And I haven't really committed to, like, these. This one and this one is high tech, I believe. Yeah, committed to going high tech yet, so we'll test it out. So I've got the orbital works going for that, and I've completed this mission. Apparently, if you want to build stargates, you have to use the active gates. You need to use. Construct astral gate, and of course you need domain error artifacts, which means you need to find a planet with vast ruins and build a specialized structure on it to loot that kind of thing. This one. Yes, artifact supply. Yeah, so you definitely need vast runes.
Yeah.
So, base production scatter runes. That's not bad, actually. But yeah, it says you need vast runes, so I'm assuming, you know, that would be the smartest thing to go. But yeah, that's that. Yeah, I heard it was vast runes, but I assume you could squeak by with that. I'm not sure. We'll see. We shall see, but that's in the future. Alright, the doctrines. I wanted to have Gauss Cannon and LRM. And then for the ship hulls, I got a carrier, that carrier, and this battleship. And then for the fighters, I just went with Papillion because they're really cool. Income is not bad, actually, but I haven't actually looked at it for a while. And I might discover something interesting while I look at them right now. So I expected the exports for my heavy industry would be the most, and that is Fed Prime. So exports 116, but look, fuel is even more, which is really weird. And my mining actually gets me more. So I thought this would outstrip, like these I thought would completely outstrip everything, which is quite interesting. I don't know why that is. I thought would be my main cash cow, but it's not. So those thinking that going into heavy industry right away will give you the maximum amount, it's not. It's really weird. We'll go look at its it might actually be consuming so much that it doesn't get a lot. 4%. Yeah, 5% of the market. But it's not really pulling it. You'd think it would pull in more. Yeah, it's quite interesting. Heavy batteries, so I would probably make a lot more revenue if I didn't have all this stuff, I'm assuming. So this might help. I'm not sure. I'm not sure how the whole credits for a month work based on what your needs are and what your exports are. I don't do math well, so I wouldn't be able to say. But yeah, definitely it's definitely I'm hoping I'm self-sufficient right now. I seem to be. I'm not sure how this, I'm sure this is just local and it's not taking into account, like, what's this? Import volume in factions, so yay. Yeah, so I'm able to pretty much, so it's local, so I'm assuming this is local and this is imported from faction and this is import from, you know, I don't produce it myself, so yeah. So I'm fairly sure, I'm not sure how being self-sufficient increases your revenue. I assume it does. Anyways, so there we go. That's that. Red planet I'm gonna ignore because it's down in the corner. Agents. I want to move her to the biggest military pirate base, and that's Karas. I'm not sure if it matters what location she's at for the actions. I'm just assuming it might. So that's queued up. And how am I looking with factions? So welcoming for Diablo and Kador still need to work on that. So I'll get her queued. Okay, pure. Alright, she's raising. Alright, cool. Alright, she'll stick with that for a while. Cool, cool. I tagged all my local as important, everything else is not. Gonna head to Manchester, and I'm metagaming it. We know there's automated stuff there, so it's not just the pirate base, and we're gonna go there and take advantage of the pirate base by not shooting at the pirates, to use the refitting and refueling and all that stuff, until the Kator remnant or we destroy it. And that is that. I think I'm ready. And yeah, let's go. Wait. One more check. Yeah. Lol. Interesting. I swear I'd remove that. Maybe that's why I'm having so much trouble in the simulator, perhaps, because it was ghosted in. It could be an artifact of the system. Mod bug or something, who knows. So I've got 4 tugs, yay. This actually isn't a... It doesn't... Even though it's reckless, the hull must, the way it works, it's not really charging in a lot as I want. I think I remember this from ages ago when I tried it as a pursuit vessel. It just didn't want to charge in a lot, which was annoying. Yeah, even if you had really short range stuff. Alright. Really. It's really cheap though, because it's got so many. So I'll keep it around. It's just meh. Meh. I won't worry about it too much. Alright. We'll save the game and then head onwards.